thing you keep telling me is the reason you are not using ChatGPT, and quite frankly, it's also the reason I don't use ChatGPT, is because of the challenge of getting it to write in your voice. ChatGPT is notorious at this point for cranking out the most robotic, cliche sounding phrases like unleash the power of, or rocketship emojis, unlock your potential. No, but seriously, why is ChatGPT so obsessed with rocketship emojis? I've actually got a list of phrases that I tell ChatGPT not to use in the description box below this video. Watch this video until the end for the 5 steps I use to get ChatGPT writing in as close to my voice as possible. Before we write the ChatGPT prompts, we need to address the question, what is voice? According to Indeed.com, voice refers to the unique style, personality, or perspective of a piece of writing. Think about the times that you've read something and thought, that doesn't sound anything like me, or I would never say that, or that sounds just like me, or that sounds just like something I would say. That is evidence of your voice. We're gonna break voice down into 4 categories for the purpose of getting ChatGPT to recognize the correct elements of voice in our writing. And those elements are as follows: voice, tone, vocabulary, and sentence structure. Together, those 4 elements are gonna make up the style guide for your writing. When we talk about voice, we're talking about the container of the personality of your writing. If we were to relate this to something like your personal style, this would be generally the style that you gravitate towards, that somebody knows, oh, that looks like something that Courtney would wear, or that looks like something that so-and-so would wear, or I could never imagine so-and-so wearing that. When we talk about tone, we're talking about something more contextual. Maybe there's a different emotion you're trying to evoke, or it's a different type of event that you're dressing for. That means you might adjust the way that you're speaking for different contexts, different types of copy, etc. Vocabulary is probably the easiest one to explain, is generally the types of words and language that you use in your writing. And this one's a really important one for ChatGPT to recognize, because there's going to be certain words you actually use over and over again that we need ChatGPT to pick up on in order for it to sound like you, in order for it to really feel like you're writing. Finally, sentence structure is all about how you tend to arrange your sentences grammatically. Sometimes some people might write in more short, easy, simple sentences. Some people are more verbose. I know that I have a tendency to use lots of ellipses and almost interrupt myself with parentheses. It's kind of an ADHD trait. Some people vary their sentence structure a lot, and some people stick to more simple sentence structure. And that's something that ChatGPT has the capability to pick up on that you probably have no interest in analyzing yourself. All right, let's hop over into ChatGPT and start to get it to write in your voice. Okay, really quick, let me give you those 5 steps we're about to implement inside of ChatGPT. So first, we're gonna open a new chat. Then we're going to feed it evidence of your voice. We're going to prompt it to generate a style guide for you. Then we're going to tweak that. And then we're going to actually prompt ChatGPT to start creating things in your voice. Step number 1 is to open your new chat inside of ChatGPT. We are using the free version for the purposes of this video. And you will need to start a new chat and do this prompt every time that you want ChatGPT to write in your voice. However, you can save the style guide and then reprompt ChatGPT every time with your voice. But with the free version, you will have to prompt the ChatGPT with your voice every single time. And this is one of the perks of upgrading to the pro version. Step number 2 is probably the most important part. We need to gather evidence of your voice. Now, this could be blog posts, email newsletters, or marketing emails. It could be YouTube video transcripts, podcast transcripts, or transcripts of voice recordings, which are my favorite to have you actually speaking, because that's gonna be the closest thing to resemble your voice. They could also be sales content, sales pages, and things like that. So you wanna find examples that you think are the best examples of your voice out there. It could be any copy on your website. Maybe you're especially happy with your about page or your homepage. That's the copy that we want to collect. Now, I personally really like to use transcripts of actual spoken voice recordings of myself, like YouTube videos or podcast recordings or just voice memos. If you don't have YouTube or podcast, just like go talk about a topic,
hopefully maybe the topic that you want to create copy for, and do a voice recording on your phone. And what I do is I go over to rev.com and I go over to their transcription services, and I go to their AI transcription. It's incredibly fast. It's super cheap. I am not an affiliate for this, but this is the service that we use to create all of our transcripts for our YouTube videos, podcasts, etc. And so when I want to create copy, one of the first things I do is I go, hey, I'm going to do a voice recording on this. I'm going to get transcribed, and we're going to start there. And that's how we create blog posts and things like that, because I come up with the content way better spoken than I do when I try to write it myself.
All right, step number three, now it's time to actually prompt ChatGPT with examples of your writing. So there's two parts to this. There's the actual prompt that we're going to use, and then I want you to feed ChatGPT three examples of your writing, and I would get like a good section of writing. I don't give it the smallest amount of text possible. It doesn't have to be a dissertation, but like a page of copy or a good chunk of copy is great for each example. So let me show you what that's gonna look like.
All right, I've got ChatGPT open here, and I've got my prompt here. This is the prompt that you're going to use. We'll put this in the description box below this video. It says, analyze the following text for tone of voice, style, vocabulary, and sentence structure. Generate a style guide for writing according to those elements. And I'm realizing this one says, well, we're going to change this to tone for the sake of staying with those four elements we talked about earlier. And then we're going to insert our examples of copy. So let's do that now. All right, I've plugged in all of my examples of copy. I used a transcription from a YouTube video. I used a bit of copy from one of my sales pages, and then, my homepage or sales page. And then I found one of my favorite best performing email newsletters that I think is really accurate to my tone. And now I'm going to go ahead and submit that to ChatGPT, and we're gonna see what ChatGPT comes up with. So now ChatGPT has given its response. The style guide, tone of voice is conversational, empathetic, encouraging, and energetic. I would say that's pretty accurate. The tone is supportive, informative, and inspirational. Yeah, sure. Vocabulary, everyday language, positive language, relatable language. Okay, interesting. Clear and concise, varied structure, action-oriented in terms of sentence structure. I would say that's very accurate for me as well. All right, so let's move on to the next step, which is where we get to actually tweak this and challenge ChatGPT to like do even better.
What you might notice from the style guide that ChatGPT has produced is it's still a little bit vague. And I feel like if I use that style guide to produce content, it could go in a lot of different directions, like support it. Like, I feel like it could get really cliche really fast. So what I actually want to challenge ChatGPT to do is to generate some more specific phrases that I can use in my content and copy that are in alignment with that style guide and with my voice. I would rather have a collection of phrases that I can use and I can refer to again and again and again and save somewhere like that I can use when I write my own copy than to have sort of this general idea of what my voice and tone is.
Here's what I'm gonna do, and I've never done it like this before, so you're here to do this experiment with me. I really want ChatGPT to give me examples of what is conversational in my writing, what is empathetic, what is energetic, what is informative, what is everyday language. The prompt I'm gonna give it is, give me three examples of words and phrases used in my text for each bullet point in the above style guide. Let's see what happens. I don't know. This is part of the ChatGPT experience, is testing these things out. So this is great. This is exactly what I wanted it to do. That worked really well, is conversational. Let's talk about the thing holding you back. Seriously, it's always the really empathic and spiritual folks. So what do you do about it? Empathetic, fear. Okay, cool. Okay, so now I have some actual examples of writing that made it say what it said about my voice. Now let's try to like start to use this to create copy in the future, to create things that don't exist yet.
Ooh, but really quick, let's feed ChatGPT that list of words, phrases, and rocketship emojis that I don't want it to use in my copy. Of course, I can always delete an emoji, and obviously you're gonna have to edit this copy later anyway. You should never just take ChatGPT and plug it in. You should always revise it. But here's me, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to plug in my list of language I don't want ChatGPT to use. And this list is gonna be constantly evolving, so make sure to check out that Google Doc in the description box below of the language that I don't want ChatGPT to use in my writing. Now what we wanna do is to give ChatGPT some random tasks to do in my voice so I can continue tweaking the voice and make sure that it's getting as close as possible. So here's what I'm gonna have ChatGPT do, and then here's how I'm going to tweak the voice thereafter.
All right, so I'm just gonna give it this silly task to use my voice, tone, vocabulary, and sentence structure to write an email to Beyonce proclaiming my love of her Cowboy Carter album, which I haven't listened to really, by the way, and I'm honestly not even a fan of country music, but I got mad respect for Beyonce, so let's just see what happens. This is a task I don't care about, I don't take it seriously, it's not a real thing that I needed to do, and I think that's a good thing to start with, so let's see what ChatGPT comes up with. Subject appreciation for a Cowboy Carter album. Okay, I don't love that subject. I think it should be more clever. Like, I'm not that boring in my writing. Hey Beyonce, I hope this email finds you well. Absolutely hate when emails start with that, so we're gonna get rid of that. I just wanna take a moment to express my absolute adoration for your Cowboy Carter album. From the first note to the last, it's been an incredible journey filled with soulful melodies and powerful lyrics. Your music has always resonated with me, but Cowboy Carter takes it to a whole new level. The way you blend different genres seamlessly while still maintaining signature Beyonce magic is truly awe-inspiring. Okay, so I feel like it sounds conversational, empathetic, and things like that, but as usual, ChatGPT is just a little vague and a little cliche. And so this is gonna go back to when you're actually prompting ChatGPT to do specific tasks, like writing a specific email, or as I talked about in my previous video on ChatGPT is generating sales page copy, we actually need to feed it more information, more details about what you want it to say. And what we could do in this one, because it is a little bit more about voice and less about the content, because I haven't listened to the album, I can't say specific songs that I love or didn't love, but I do want it to be a little bit more clever. So here's what I'm going to do. So I'm gonna have it give me 10 alternate subject lines for the above email that are more clever, cheeky, and specific. I didn't really use my style guide for that. Those are just things I wanted. And I think these are a lot better. Send out Beyonce, my Cowboy Carter confession. Okay, maybe it's a little cliche, but I think that's way better. Yeehaw, gushing over Cowboy. These are much better. So these are gonna give me some ideas. I might not use these specific ones, but I feel like these are feeling a lot more like my voice, which means I might wanna make sure that I'm using words like clever and cheeky in my brand voice, because that seems to be getting more to my voice.
In my opinion, the best way to use ChatGPT to help you generate copy in your voice is to give it very specific tasks to generate lots of ideas for a very specific phrase of copy, just like I did for that subject line for my email to Beyonce, right? Is if I can just focus on a subject line or just focus on one point, I can actually have ChatGPT come up with lots of different examples for me and then take it from there. I think that, in my opinion, is the best use of ChatGPT, at least the free version of ChatGPT at this moment. I'm gonna be coming up with a lot more videos for very specific tasks for ChatGPT in upcoming videos, obviously. And I also have a video I did recently on how to use ChatGPT to write your sales page copy for you, which is a massive project for ChatGPT. So watch this video to see how I break down the sales page copy into very specific tasks for ChatGPT, but you're going to need this video that you just watched as that sort of foundational work in order to make sure that whatever piece of content that you're having ChatGPT write, it is able to do so in your voice. And then you can use the more specific videos to then create specific pieces of copy.